Hi, I'm Bob Jeffrey here in China, and welcome to today's edition of Worldmakers.
Modern China is about cultural collision. From Shanghai's stock exchange to Beijing's ancient treasures, the world's best brands know that to succeed here, you must do more than speak Mandarin. You must understand the motivations unique to this market and the people. Today, we'll learn what it takes to be world-made in China. Welcome to Worldmakers. Today, I'm sitting down with Mr. Yang, contemporary artist. Mr. Yang, welcome to Worldmakers. It's great to have you here.
谢谢JWT给我带来这样的一个机会，可以讨论一些问题。
Can you describe to me what it's like to be an artist in China? Like, who are you trying to reach? What, you know, really has inspired you?
我觉得在中国目前的状况就是，可能意味着很多方面，就是作为一个艺术家，他可能对历史、文化、政治都会产生一些影响。 然后，但是对作为我来说，我认为艺术对我而言只是一份工作，然后只是让我从事我喜爱的事情。然后，但是不同的是，它有一个更自由的环境和空间。In
advertising, there's a huge transformation going on, where it's not just about traditional anymore. It includes digital and other types of technological innovation. And I'm just curious how you look at that in terms of advertising, technology, innovation, and so on.
我觉得当今的当代艺术和广告或者是技术这些层面，我觉得他们的界限越来越模糊了。然后当今的艺术也引用了很多广告上面会使用的一些技术，同样在广告方面也会运用一些艺术方面的表现手法，所以我觉得他们的是已经成为一个整体化的一个概念。 然后我觉得他们之间的最大的区别就在于，广告它是有一个具体的客户的。然后从事艺术的话，可能你的客户就是自己。So
let me ask you this: I mean, China has been growing so rapidly from an economic point of view. How do you balance out the forces of change and modernization versus, say, the forces of tradition and history?
我觉得现代化的进程在以一种急速的速度去吞噬任何东西。 它包括历史、文化，就是一些人文，甚至是我们所谓中国人很看重的一种亲情、一种人情味，现在越来越丧失了。其实，作为我的观点来说，我觉得，发展是必须的，但是我觉得是不是应该考虑在发展的背后去保留一些，或者是去保护一些我们应该原来拥有的一些东西，就是。 不至于到若干年之后，就是连一些痕迹都找不到。我觉得这个是很可怕的。So
let me ask you this: Does that challenge inspire you for the type of art that you create? In terms of even though the country is getting more modernized, but making sure that we don't lose that sense of tradition and history.
对，这个可能也是我创作作品的初衷。然后，当然这些大环境它是会对我产生巨大的影响。
One of the observations I've had is that more and more people are interested in the art market from China around the world. That global interest in the art market here, what kind of impact do you think that will have on the artist community here in China?
我觉得中国在改革开放之后的，从八五年开始的那些，获得了前所未有的就是国际上的关注。那我觉得这个。 对于艺术家来讲，这当然是一个非常好的机会，所以就是这样。So
let me ask you a question. If a young person were asking you for the best advice to become an artist, and given what's going on in the world with technology and digital and so on, what kind of advice would you give a young person who wants to pursue an artistic career?
我觉得就是我想说的就是说我首先会问这个年轻人，你是不是真正的热爱艺术？ 如果你真正热爱艺术，我非常就是鼓励你去从事它。但是如果你是为了其他原因，比如说为了钱、为了名利，那我觉得它其实到最后是很难去走到自己的内心深处，因为你一开始的初衷就是想利用它。因为对我来说，我觉得艺术其实就是你的一面镜子，它可以很完全全的把你的内心世界反映出来。 它从很潜意识的会表达你那此时此刻你的状态和你在思考些什么，所以 我觉得他是没办法骗人的。如果你内心深处有一点点不纯粹的地方，他都能显现出来。
Mr. Yang, this has been great. Thank you for joining us on Worldmakers. And thank you for tuning into Worldmakers here in Shanghai.